It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. Four reasons why a southeastern president will not actualize Biafra nation. In the southeastern part of Nigeria, the agitations by the independent people of Biafra, IPO, for the release of their leader, Nnamdi Kanu, and the actualization of Biafra nation get stronger by the passage of each day. And one of the consequences is the attendant insecurity of lives and property in the process. But one major way in which the old scenarios have been surprising to the general members of the public is the fact that the well-meaning ones among the Igbos have been assassinated in the course of wanton activities, who are mostly credited to the unknown gunmen. Meanwhile, as a result of the nagging struggles by the IPOB to secede from Nigeria, the quest by the southern politicians to occupy the position of the president of the country in 2023 by way of power rotation have been receiving resistance by the northern political elite. This is even more so as calls have been made for an Igbo president to emerge at the next 2 years presidential election, but the necessitations being held up, being put up by the northerners stem from their apprehension that such one, an Igbo president, will eventually grant the IPOB their request to break out of the country, Nigeria. Even the former chairman of their communication, Chief Raymond Tokwesi, who is not a northerner, has also confirmed this. But despite all the fears by many people, a southeastern president might not assent to the quest by the IPOB to secede from Nigeria due to the following reasons. 1. If an Igbo man emerges as the president-elect in 2023, he will have to take an oath of service, oath of office, before he assumes duty, and the oath will involve that he will not work against the unity of the country. Many people might portray such an oath taken as an inconsequential act. However, it is worth respecting, especially as it is usually involved the use of Holy Bible and Quran, which are very divine and powerful religious books, that their potencies cannot be underestimated. So, a God-fearing southeastern president will not want to flout the terms of such oaths. 2. Many Igbos are not in support of the calls by the IPOB that the southeast should be granted political autonomy from the rest of Nigeria. This is simply due to the fact that they believe more in the continuous unity of the country than a division. Thus, a southeastern president will want to play along with such ones. 3. Many Igbo indigenes are well established in all other parts of the country. Most of them are scared that the country divided. With the country divided, they will lose all their donkey years that they toiled for. As a result, they might just win the favor of possible Igbo president by him not agreeing to allow Nigeria to break up. 4. A southeastern president might put the late Odumegwu Ojukwu factor to play by saying that Ojukwu factor, it means that albeit he first championed the agitations for the creation of Biafra nation to the point of a bloody civil war, he later repented of his standpoint by swaying for the unity of the country. And at the time, he also partook in the electioneering processes in the country, to the extent of being a co-founding father of the political party that is known as the All Progressive Grand Alliance, APGA, under which he also contested for the post of the President of Nigeria in 2003. In consideration of this, such a likely southeastern president might also decidedly told the part of unity that the late Ojukwu embraced after the Civil War. And this is the analysis by one of the public analysis and writers, who is trying to overview the sayings that a southeastern president will actualize Biafra nation, saying that a southern president, if become a president elect for 2023, may not actualize the Biafra Nation agitation, contrary to different types of sayings and analysis that a southern president might end up breaking up the country, and that we might continue to suffer just like the consequences that we are facing now, that is insecurity of lives and properties, and a whole lot of things that might happen, because now we have had well-meaning Nigerians being assassinated and being credited to unknown gunmen in the process, and the general members of the public are of the fact that all these things are still due to the agitations to secede from Nigeria and the quest by southern politicians to occupy the position of the president of the country in 2023, saying that there should be a power rotation to the southeast, who has actually not had the privilege to produce a president before, of which the northern political elites had actually been against, saying that doing so can actually make Nigeria prone to break up. Even the former chairman of DA Communication, known as Chief Raymond Tokwesi, who is actually not a northerner, also confirmed this, saying that the fears by many people might actually come to play, because at the end of the day, it might affect the strong unity and of Nigeria. And the analyst is of the opinion that this might not ascend, might not ascend to the quest by the IPOB to secede from Nigeria, that even if they consider a southern president, that they might not break up from Nigeria, might not allow secession to happen, seeing that the reasons for saying so is because, number one, anyone that would assume the presidential seat must actually swear an oath of office, and the oath of office would actually mandate that anyone who is going to be the president of the country must ensure that the country unity does not break up, seeing that although people take this oath as something normal, but that it is worth respecting, because they make use of the two powerful religious books, which are the Bible and the Quran, and we know that their potencies cannot be underestimated. And secondly, that the southeastern people are not in support of the indigenous people of Biafra, and that they cannot be granted political autonomy, seeing that the continuous unity of the country as well, that is the third one, might actually make the Igbos lose the whole lot of investment they have in other places of the country if they eventually break up. And at lastly, that even Ojukwu, that started this, at the end of the day, he later repented of his standpoint by swaying for the unity of the country, saying that anyone that emerges also will know that there is need to embrace unity, which Ojukwu later did after the Civil War. Thanks for listening.